So in today's video, we're going to be playing Median XL's new 1.7 update on hardcore, so when we die, our character's dead. And we're going to be playing solo self-found, so no trading from other characters. Median has a cool crafting system, so we can make any gear that we want. And this video is going to be farming up this Naginata, which we're going to be testing in the next video. First, we're just going to go through the skills. So we got Backstab, a melee strike that cloaks you in shadow. I didn't even notice this, but the ability we just picked up requires a Naginata, so we're going to gamble for one. So I gambled, I want to say like 20 to 25 times, did not find a Naginata, so I'm guessing they're just not something you can gamble for. Like, I found these halberds a lot, they were like every other time. Maybe you just can't gamble for them on the first level. So yeah, for now we're gonna keep using auto attacks. We attacked really fast with just a white claw, and we did level up again. We're now gonna try this ability Crucify, which just requires melee weapon. Okay, so those guys died before I could even get down there. It does some AoE damage. Really good AoE damage by the looks of it. At least for our what we're trying to do right now, which is just get some AoE. And we got a Stamina Shrine, which is very nice. It's going to help us clear out the Den of Evil with speed, as we can perma run now. Under hotkeys, there's a button where it allows you to actually toggle run on. It's not enabled by default, but yeah, definitely recommend doing that. And ooh, this is going to be actually a little bit sketchy. There's a lot of dudes here we leveled up. Holy crap, I don't know how those guys died. We got an Ith rune, by the way. We might be able to make a rune rule with that. So yeah, this is gonna be a lot more exciting to play this way, I think, because before I had so many runes. Like, once I got to 108, I think I was stopped at, I just had an infinite rune supply, and it was gonna make the game way too easy. There's something about just starting with nothing that is actually just kind of exciting to me. Oh, here we go. These are the last two minions, I think, in the... Yep, we cleared it out. So we can now respec if we want to, which we're not going to be respecing. Oh, another Stamina Shrine. Beautiful. We're not going to go back to town for a while. We're just going to keep spamming this ability until it looks like it starts to suck, I guess. Or until a Stamina Shrine runs out, and then we'll look at another ability. But yeah, for now, I want to go fast. All right, we got an XP Shrine now. The XP is about to go super high quickly. Oh, we're actually taking damage. It's a bit scary. Got a short sword, our first rare. Some blue boots too. Always pick up the boots because they could be really high roll on the movement speed. There's a big variance in boots. I mean this like early game when you can't afford to just craft boots and re-roll them. Oh, and we got leather armor. Let's make sure we don't get killed by these quill bears. Apparently these are doing good physical damage to us, I think. Oh, and here we go, our first boss. So I think I'm definitely gonna go back to town before we take on this boss. So we have that rune, and I wanna use that potentially on a rune word, even though I don't think we're high enough level. Oh yeah, we don't wanna die here. Let's put this safe. We do get a mercenary if we can kill this boss, and mercenaries are super good in this mode, so it is definitely worth it if we can take the boss. And we got this Imphorn flying knife, requires 53 dex. We might be able to get up there. Oh yeah, we can get up there for sure. 53, let's put that on. And let's now go for this ability Scorpion Blade, and let's also go for Storm Crows, which are both throwing skills. Let's see if we have any passives. We have this ability Blink, which is like teleport from D2. It's a bit less powerful version of it. And then we do have a passive, enables you to inflict powerful poisonous attacks, adds poison damage the weapon. So yeah, we'll go for those. It looks like it's pretty good to put points in a way of the spider too. It increases the poison damage from 1 to 3 to 3 to 6. Let's try out. It looks like this is the AoE ability. Oh yeah, nice. We got some AoE throwing already, which is awesome. We're doing damage from range, which is something that I wasn't really able to do in my last playthrough. And we got good single target. This is actually already turning out to be better than my other build. I don't know, the throwing poison barbarian was not the most fun build to play, let's put it that way. Oh, we just killed Blood Raven, I think. These things do home, and I guess they homed on the Blood Raven. So yeah, we can just sit back here and be safe and just toss these out, and they're gonna seek people. All right, let's talk to this girl. Let's get a mercenary for sure. It's going to cost us not that much. I don't know what the difference between Priestess and Ranger is. We could actually test it out. Let's just hire the cheapest Ranger they got, level 4 one. Mako has Barrage level 1, which is a skill that fires arrows in all directions around her. And Trinity Arrow is a bow skill that fires an overhead shot, which deals elemental damage. So that was the Ranger. We're going to hire the highest level Priestess they got, because we'll just stick with the Priestess. I don't really know which one's going to be better. The Priestess does also have Barrage, but then she has this ability Heartseeker, and I don't actually know what that does. So we're just gonna find out, I guess. Let's actually use this chest piece for that 3% extra juicy gold find. I didn't notice this. We actually have this yellow chest piece, 4% more gold and magic find, and 1 life regen per second. Very nice. But yeah, we made it over to the Stony Field and we're fighting Chupacabras, a boss. And yeah, we're just gonna sit back and just toss knives. This isn't the most interesting build, I will admit. And we will switch it up once we get a Naginata. Or maybe we'll just keep going until we kind of just out-level this part of the build. Because there's a crafted Naginata that I won't eventually make, but we're pretty far away from being able to do that. So yeah, oh, very nice Nephrine. And a large shield, requires 22 strength, it's indestructible, wow. I don't know if that's the most useful stat, but it does give us 1 life regen per second, which is nice. And I think it gives us a bit more armor too. We're gonna hit up Underground Patches level 2 because there's a chest in here. I'm kind of curious to see what's inside of it. You don't have to go here if you're just trying to get through the, holy crap. These mobs are actually not messing around, by the way. Oh, there's a unique mob, that's why. Let's poison him. And then, okay, yeah, I don't know. I mean, we were using our single target ability, but it didn't look like it was doing any extra damage. Got a yellow cap, very nice. A little bit more defense, some lightning res, some physical damage taken, I believe, reduced by 4, so that's nice. But yeah, for the chest, it is locked, actually. We're gonna have to go back to get a key, I think. Oh, there's a lot of mobs here. This is very nice. A lot of XP. Take it. Holy crap, we got a light crossbow. I was not expecting to get a unique that early. We're getting bombarded by something over here. It's Warforged Shaman. We got an L rune too, by the way. And we got a tier rune over here. Okay. This place just keeps on giving. I'm really glad we went in here. And that's another level up. And what? Another unique? Holy crap, dude. Okay, before I look at the uniques, I do kind of want to... Okay, we don't have to unlock the chest, I guess. We have keys. We got this Rune Shatter White Crossbow now, which gives +9 to Cluster Bomb. Why do I feel like that's an assassin skill? Just sounds like something an assassin would be using. A lot of bonuses to life, too, which is going to be good for our hardcore playstyle. It also increases cast speed. I was going to say the issue with it is we have to go down the Trapper Tree, which allows us to only use traps, melee, summoning, and buff debuff skills. I guess we can't use throwing anymore. But there's no Cluster Bomb here. All right, so apparently Assassin was reworked. Subterfuge is actually a new ability, and she no longer does have Cluster Bomb. We do have a really high rank of it though, level 9. And so yeah, we're gonna use that skill for now, and let's see how that works. I'm really not sure, like it's hard to tell, there's just too much AoE going down. I don't know if we're actually killing stuff. Okay, it looks like we are. Hard to tell, like it lays down a bunch of traps, I think, once it blows up, and yeah, it does decent AoE, I think. Is it doing what we should be expecting from a unique? I don't really know. And the hexblade we got is a necromancer weapon. It gives level 1 demon blood aura, which increases the party's maximum life and elemental spell damage. So it's good for like a summoning necromancer. Like maybe if we went down the trapper tree, this would be doing more damage, but I just don't think it's worth. We'd have to potentially respec if we found like a really good throwing knife. I don't want to deal with that. But yeah, we're in the dark wood now. And the trees spawn really close to the cave entrance. That's kind of a weird thing that I've never seen. We'll say we are doing really crap damage right now, it feels like. Although this thing's a unique or rare mob. We do have an extra survivability, so maybe there's a trade-off there. But yeah, this thing just costs so much mana to use, this Cluster Bomb ability. Can't say I'm exactly a fan of the ability. I'm a fan of the HP, so we will keep using it. Unfortunately, we don't have any skills also that we can use with crossbows. So yeah, we're kind of stuck spamming this thing. We also got a chest piece upgrade. This thing gives a bit more armor and 8% magic find. Because this ability is so high level, it costs tons of mana. I think that's the main problem with it. And it just isn't that good, I feel. I think that's why they dumped the ability. Just, I don't know, just feel like good to use. I mean, there's other abilities that don't feel like good to use that the Barbarian had, I guess. So maybe that wasn't the reason. I don't know. But yeah, overall, I'm not a huge fan of it. It does own Griswold, though. He has stone skin, so he takes less damage from physical. But Magical does not care about his stone skin. All right, we made it to the top of the Forgotten Tower. And we're about to get some fat runes, potentially. It's always exciting. And we're out of mana. That's just the story. Oh, nice, we leveled up. The story of this whole early game is we're just out of mana completely all the time. It's not the most fun. I could actually use this crossbow as just a ranged weapon and get like a bolt or a quiver of bolts. And here we go. We got a Mal rune. That's actually a high level rune, I think. It's a level 49 rune we got from this place. I remember I ran this on hell and I got like nothing even close to this. So that was actually pretty lucky. And yeah, you can only do it once, I think. I'm like very sure that you can only do it once. But yeah, hopefully we can make something good with that Mal rune. We're going to make Lumen Arcana in this hard leather armor. It requires the sockets to be filled up to 1 and then just an Ith rune. And it gives +1 to all skills, lowers enemy resistances by a random amount from 3 to 8, and then increases the defense on the chest piece and gives plus 2 to light radius so we can see more. There's a lot of mobs back there. Ooh, a tower shield. We might be able to finally switch out of this infernal crossbow build we got going on. The ivory tower, plus 1 to all skills, and it gives a lot of defense, 443. Yeah, that's more than all of our defense combined right now. The question is, what would we use this with? For now, we could just put it in our secondary slot, and we could swap out between the crossbow for huge AoE, and then these throwing knives for good single target. I didn't notice this, but we do have this buff Queen of Blades that periodically launches bouncing blades at nearby enemies. We also have Way of the Phoenix, which is another passive. It allows us to deal more damage with our attacks. I think we just rank up all of our passives for now, and like after doing that, I looked at the damage of this cluster bomb and it's only dealing 13 to 21 damage. Our scorpion blade, the dagger throwing ability, is doing 56 to 80, and then our AoE throwing ability is dealing 54 to 97. So yeah, we're done with that crossbow. That thing is literally just going to the trash, I'm sure. Yeah, we're dealing way more damage now, and it's just way more easy to cast this. These abilities, we gotta not die here. Holy crap. So yeah, we're lacking on the survivability a bit. I almost died there, actually. And now for this boss, Blightfire. Let's see. Oh yeah, we're doing good damage to him. I can't really just sit there and spam at him. Let's actually bat here for a second. Alright, we made it to Andariel's lair, and we have a few more abilities now for our throwing weapons. So we have this thing where we throw it, and it will throw out spikes as it moves. It's actually a really good AoE ability. And like, we can just throw it in this room, and it will pretty much wipe stuff out for us. We didn't even rank it up, really. We only put 1 point to it, I think. Yeah, it's only base level 1. We have two things that are giving us skill level bonuses. Gotta be careful here. But yeah, so it's actually level 3 now, because we got our shield that's giving us plus 1 to all skills, and then our chest piece. So here comes the Andariel fight. I feel like this should be pretty easy in terms of, I don't know, I feel like we're really tanky. And yeah, she's already going down. He's attacking our mercenary, and she's doing no damage to it. Like, literally doing no damage to the mercenary, so we should be good, I think. Watch out for her fire ability. Even though it looks like she's not gonna be able to cast it before she dies. Gonna cast it, or are you just gonna not? Okay, yeah, she's gonna go down. Light plate, and we got the Catalyst of Disenchantment, so we could actually make the Naginata right now if we wanted to. This Dragon's Blood light plate is kind of weird. It gives 17 life after each demon kill, 35 vitality, increased physical and magical spell damage, increased fire spell damage, more cast speed, and 4% chance to cast level 8 Wrath on melee attack. I will say it does have a lot of armor, and that 35 vitality is quite a lot, so maybe we should put enough strength onto our character in order to be able to use it, although we need a lot of strength, because we are only at 25 strength, but we will need more strength to be able to use like some of the better gear. So yeah, we'll just put enough points in his strength to be able to use it, and I guess we'll use it over our chest piece, even though we'd be losing on the plus 1 to all skills. Be gaining vitality, a lot of armor. Is it worth? I mean, it's definitely worth for fighting demons. We get infinite survivability pretty much. Like, that 17 life per kill is so much. In order to be able to craft the Naginata, we'd need to destroy all of our uniques, including the ivory tower. And I will say, the longer we wait to craft it, the better, because we might be able to just wait until we can get a tier 2 Naginata, which is gonna be a lot better than a tier 1. And like, we could upgrade the tier 1, but it would cost another arcane crystal, so that's 5 more uniques we'd have to destroy to be able to upgrade it. I'd rather just hold out until we can get the tier 2 Naginata, which I don't know when tier 2 things start dropping. Like, I'm gonna keep an eye out, because right now all we're seeing is tier 1 stuff. We also do have this one socketed helmet that if we put an L rune in it, it makes summit, which gives us more gold fine and reduces vendor prices. That's literally pretty much all it does. But yeah, we're gonna just get that extra gold fine for now, because gold in this game is actually really useful, and that lowered vendor prices will be useful too if I can remember to use it when we're using the vendor. All right, now for Radamant. These are all demons, by the way, so every time we kill one of them, we're just getting tons of life back. All right, I guess we killed them all pretty quickly. I still don't know about the chest piece we're using. Okay, wait, we're not even using it? Oh, I didn't have no strength to use it. Need one more. I guess I swapped out some of my gear. So yeah, we were actually not doing more damage to demons. We were losing out a lot of armor and vitality and stuff too. I don't know how long that was going on for, but that was a massive fail. And Radamant is already dead. Holy crap. Just dying to the mercenary, I guess, for the most part. But yeah, we picked up this really nice superior full plate mail. It got a really good roll on the defense, 28 out of 35. It requires 91 strength, but we're almost there anyways. We're just going to go for that. And yeah, we're going to make a rune word out of this. The same one that we were using, we're going to dump this jewel into it for more gold find. And yeah, we're just going to dump another ith. We even have another ith. Okay, we actually have 2 more iths. So yeah, these are not that rare for us. But yeah, this Lumen Arcana gives us 828 defense, plus a bonus to all skills. I just don't think the damage to demons is all that worth for this thing. Maybe if we're fighting like a group of demons, we can swap a chest piece pieces or something. Well, there we go. We got a tier 2 item now. Boots, tier 2. I think tier 2 boots actually have a higher chance to get movement speed, like more movement speed. Well, these gave the same actually as the ones we're using, 15. But yeah, we're starting to get tier 2 stuff now. So I think once we find a tier 2 Naginata, we will turn that into the unique. And yeah, I don't know. There's no point of even dropping that portal there. If we die on Duriel, then we're done for. We're gonna drop our spike trap thing and just pretty good damage. And yeah, I think we're okay here. Like, we have good armor. That spike trap, by the way, has a long cooldown. It's got like a 12 second cooldown. I can't just spam it. And yeah, Duriel is super easy on normal, I guess. At least with the type of gear we have right now. We have a really good chest piece, a lot of armor. Mercenary is just tanking Duriel, by the way. Spike trap for the win. Yep. And we got a crown, very nice. That's definitely something we could potentially use. It's a poison spell damage crown, which we do have poison spell damage right now. That would give us not that much damage, actually. It gives us poison resist, which is nice, and increases our total defense, I guess, across our entire character by 20%, so that's nice. It also lowers enemy poison resist, and like that does not factor in. So we're just progressing through Act 3 pretty well. Keeping an eye out for a tier 2 Naginata. I tried to gamble for one. I don't think it's possible to get a tier 2 one at our level. I think we need to go to the next act, because I gambled like 40 times, found like 8 Naginatas. Apparently you have to be level 8 to gamble for one, or at least higher than level 1. One thing I've actually noticed, and this is going to be kind of hard to explain, is like you can get a tier 2 version of these boots earlier on, like say in Act 2, I think we got them to drop, and then like in Act 3, these boots can drop, for example. I don't know the exact point at which these can start dropping, but just because we've seen tier 2 gear drop does not mean a tier 2 Naginata can drop yet. I'm thinking it's going to be very soon though, because we're seeing a lot of different types of tier 2 gear drop now. But yeah, we were just cruising along when we found this Fellblood amulet. Unfortunately, it's a really good Necromancer amulet. +2 to Necromancer skill levels. That would be amazing if it was +2 to Assassin skill levels, because the life stolen per hit, the extra life based on character level, both those stats are really good. That's a lot of life. And then there's a 3% chance to reanimate as Molting Torment. I think when we kill stuff, it can reanimate as that thing. But yeah, we're definitely gonna use that amulet. That's gonna be a lot of survivability and some extra life steal, which is nice. So we got this Superior Hunter's Bow drop. It's got a pretty good amount of enhanced damage and it gives bonus attack rating. We're gonna drop a soul in this thing. That gives it a 50% chance to cast level 14 Punishers on kill, enhances the damage as well, slows the target, and gives some bonuses to dex. We're gonna give that to our mercenary. That should give her a good amount of damage. Oh yeah, her barrage went from 8 to 12 to 35 to 79. She was just using this random short battle bow that I found. All right, we made it basically through Act 3. We're on Act 3's final boss. Overall, it's been pretty smooth sailing. Now we'll see if this boss is gonna be smooth. Oh, okay, let's actually just let our mercenary maybe solo the boss. She's doing so much damage. That's all of her. We're doing nothing. Well, we do have a passive ability that sends out daggers, but I don't think we were in close enough. There's a mechanic with Mephisto. Oh crap, we're right next to him. Whatever, maybe we just tank him. There's a mechanic where like he'll do this area thing. Arena type thing, and there he goes. And we gotta sit inside it, I think, to do damage to him. That's how that works. And yeah, we just dropped our trap. We do have a blink, so we could just blink out if we get low. Holy crap, okay. My health spiked there. I'm a little bit scared. Mainly just do not want to die before getting a chance to try out this halberd build, or the Naginata build, rather. When our mercenary died, that does not happen very often. We can reserve for 3,600. It's not much money for us. We have 137k. I think when we're outside the ring, we can't hit Mephisto. Or maybe not, actually. Okay, never mind. I don't know. He dropped a long staff and a hand axe, both tier 2. For the staff's not bad too. It gives +2 to all skills, bonuses to fire and lightning damage, and 9 to flash, 10 to apocalypse. We're currently pretty throwing spec, so we're not gonna mess around with that staff. And I don't know about the hand axe either. It gives +4 to death gaze, which is a barbarian ability, and does okay melee damage, I guess, but we can't use any of our throwing abilities with it. So yeah, I think we're just gonna end up dumping it. All right, so we've been progressing fairly well through Act 4. We did get this barbarian Ono drop. It's not something we can use, so obviously we're going to destroy it. I did realize that we actually need 10 uniques in order to make the Naginata. So yeah, I was a little bit off there. I don't know why I thought I only needed 5, which is fine. Like once we get to Act 5, we can farm them fairly easily off of one of the bosses. And I think maybe in Act 5, we'll be able to gamble for a Naginata. So yeah, we'll just have to hold out till then with this pretty mediocre build we're using right now, but it's working. And wow, we just destroyed this guy. By the way, we're summoning these golem things. I just noticed they're the Molting Torments from our necklace. I don't know if they're really doing good damage. It could have been our mercenary that just killed that thing. But yeah, we're at the Hellforge and we're going to bash this thing in. Hopefully we get some good loot here. Ist rune. That's actually a required level 51 rune. That's really good. All right, we breeze through Act 4. We're now level 42, which is a little bit worrying because our gear is kind of outdated for the most part. We're going to upgrade our boots. We're just going to drop this crappy jewel into them. We're going to drop this Ith rune into them, and that's going to make Epicenter. And we actually got the max life roll on that, which is good. That's pretty much all we wanted, 15% extra life. These boots also, I believe, had the max amount of movement speed we can get so far. Eventually, you can get 40%, but I think Tier 2 boots can only be 30. Diablo is also a demon, so we're going to use this Dragon's Blood light plate, and that's going to give us some extra damage to demons. And yeah, here we go. I think there are a lot of demons in that group. Pretty sure those Balrogs are all demons. Those Pit Lord looking things. But yeah, we actually mowed them down pretty good, and Diablo is actually pretty low for the most part. We want to avoid that, by the way. Pretty easy to avoid it when you're playing range. That's part of the reason why I feel like the Naginata build may not be the play, is because we won't be able to just sit back and poke at bosses like this. But then again, I don't know. We'll just have to get a lot of resist and a lot of armor, and we should maybe be okay. But yeah, Diablo was... Oh, 106 HP. I was about to say that fight was going so easy. Holy crap, dude. We got two uniques. Then we got an Isle rune. That's actually a nice rune. Wow, that was death if we didn't have these Epicenter boots. Holy crap. We got a Sorcerer's chest piece. Not something that we can use, so we're going to dump it. And oh no, we got another oh no. That's fine though. We'll just cube it. We're getting close to being able to get that Naginata. And there we go. We finally found it. So yeah, I gambled like, I want to say 40 times in Act 3. Couldn't find a Tier 2 Naginata, but now we finally got it. We're gonna pick it up for 5.8k gold. And wait, we already somehow have two arcane crystals. We might be able to even upgrade this Naginata to Tier 3. So yeah, for two arcane crystals plus an oil of enhancements, we're gonna make a unique Naginata. Now, first of all, before we do this, actually, I'm gonna reroll the Naginata's stats. Even though I don't think it matters for uniques, we will still reroll it to try to get some bonus damage, and we'll see if that actually affects the damage. I don't think it does. I think when it rerolls as unique, and like right here, we got 30%, that's good enough, because I'm pretty sure when it rerolls it to unique, it rerolls everything about it. So yeah, let's reroll this baby, and we're gonna hope we get good stats, even though it doesn't matter too much, I think, because we're gonna upgrade it. So the stats were pretty low, but we end up upgrading it again, so these stats actually don't matter. I'm just gonna skip the part where I explain the stats on this thing. One thing I will say is we can use the Tier 3 version of this in 5 levels, but it requires a lot of dex. 192 for the Tier 3 version of it, and right now we only have 64 dex. We're gonna put all of our points into it. That brings us up to 138. By the time we get to 47, I think we'll be close, and we could use some equipment to increase our dex, so we'll definitely be able to use it at 47. We found another unique. I don't know if this thing's any good. Requires a good amount of strength, 107, increases minion life and resist. Ugh. Yeah, it's going in the grinder. All right, we're in an elite area. I don't know if I should be here, but if we can clear this out, we might get some fat loot, perhaps. We'll get a lot of XP for being here, too. All right, we cleared out the whole thing. We got a few level ups. We're actually 46. Wait, was it 47 that we needed for the Naginata? It was. Yeah, so we just got tons of XP for this. Like, they're all elites. When we got a broadsword dropped, it probably is something that we don't need. Yeah, this raptor beak broadsword is definitely pretty bad. We're gonna cube that thing. And yeah, we're gonna dump both these Onos, this raptor beak broadsword, this summoning chest piece, which does have quite a bit of defense, and this sorceress chest piece. We're gonna dump all those for an arcane crystal, which we're gonna use to upgrade this Naginata. And this time we actually got almost the max amount of enhanced damage. It can be 126 to 149. We got 148, so one off the max damage there. The added damage was also really high. The low end can be 18 to 20. The high end can be 43 to 50. So we got, yeah, pretty much the max almost. Elemental resist was the lowest. It can be 41 to 55, and the physical resist can be 15 to 17. That, my friends, is where we're gonna end the video. In the next video, we're gonna be testing this baby out. I wanna thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one.